traveled from Columbus, Ohio, the Buckeyes of Ohio State. Some 3,000 fans are here in support of Coach Earl Bruce and the Buckeyes. And that cheer greets the arrival of Bruce's opponent this afternoon at the other entrance. Here come the Huskies. For the Buckeyes, this is their second game, but it's a season opener for the Huskies.
Very important, as you all know, Brent. They've had 2.5 weeks to iron out any problems.
The Big Ten takes on the Pac-10. Ohio State against Washington in just a moment. So we are ready to go, and there is Jeff Jaeger, one of the more talented toes in college football this year. He can wind up as the all-time scoring leader if he can score 104 points. And he takes it down, and the Buckeyes will have the first possession with Vince Workman, number 42, returning the kickoff, and he busts it out near the 30-yard line. Jim Karsatos, and there are you and I have already talked about this talent from Fullerton, California. How about the men behind him?
Big Coop, they call him. He can really bust through there. You can see he's 246 pounds.
Vince Workman, who just returned the kickoff for the Buckeyes. Nate Harris is the flanker, number 26, the main man.
And a great receiver in Chris Carter. He can do it all.
They will come with Workman. First down, they run behind the right side of the offensive line.
But they're a little young and green this year at left tackle Stasniak. Uhlenhake played last year, a very good player. This is a great one. Bob Maggs, truly an All-American candidate.
Second and 5 for the Buckeyes. And again, they will bring Workman. This time they try left outside. Which would be a first down. Here they are attacking on first down from the eye. And using Workman again up behind Maggs. You mentioned him. And it is second and 5 out of the eye for the Buckeyes.
Looks like an audible here.
Arsatos checking off. Workman has been the workhorse behind the right side, and he cannot. How about this group up front, Era?
Brian Habby, but left tackle. And Steve Albert, a very fine nose man. Reggie Rogers, truly an All-American candidate, really great speed. Steve Roberts was moved from tackle to the outside backer.
Now this is 3rd and 3. Bo Yates is the whip linebacker, as he's referred to in the Washington terminology. They pull it away from Cooper, get outside, and they stop Workman from the first down. So the backup quarterback for Coach Bruce. The side of his foot, but it got an Ohio State bounce, and it'll go out inside the 15. The workhorse is the fullback directly behind Chandler Finney, and they use him up the middle on first down. Chris Chandler from Everett, Washington, superb athlete, played baseball and basketball. Rick Finney, slowed by injuries last year, but he's healthy now.
Vince Weathersby caught 43 passes last year. Good receiver and runner.
Darrell Franklin with speed on the outside to complement the big weapon, Wanzel Hill. Rod Jones, remember that man, 84. We kept hearing rave reviews in Columbus as well as Seattle about his talents. And this is Weathersby. Daylight swings to the outside with a first down. Weathersby took advantage of it. It'll be a first down. Chandler with his first pass of the game to Hill. Some with a 2nd and 2. That ball is at the 35 coming out. Finney barrels ahead for the first down. And here are these men who are doing the job right now, Era.
This is one of the biggest college offensive lines that I've ever seen. Take a look at the sizes. Wiese is 274, Brostek 272. He's the center, has been moved from another guard. Zamdowski, watch this guy, 296. Look at Gogan, a real pro prospect, 300 pounds.
The Buckeyes with their hands full up front. First down, the ball is at the 43. Chandler keeping it. Defensive unit, Fred Ritter, one of the men up front. Look at their weights, how much smaller they are. They're giving away like 30 pounds a man against that huge offensive line. Spielman at 232, he's an All-American. John Sullivan, he has a twin brother in that lineup today, too. Second down and seven for Chandler. Swings it. Withersby across midfield. Another Washington first down. As he... Good ball possession drive by James. Here he is using Finney on a buck up. William White is in one corner. He's back from a year ago.
Greg Rogan at the right corner, number 29, got great speed. And Sonny Gordon is really the leader on this defensive secondary. Very bright youngster.
And the freshman, David Brown. He replaced Terry White, who was kicked off the team and subsequently has enrolled at West Virginia, we understand. Second and six for the Huskies, who have moved the ball. Took it inside the 15, and here's Finney. Guys do here to change up. Can they come with a blitz?
I think they're a little off balance by some of these new formations that they're looking at.
Weathersby was losing his balance. Second down and eight. Still another formation. Chandler throwing toward Franklin. Knocked away. Third and eight. This is the 11th play. Ball is turned loose by the quarterback, and the Buckeyes have got the turnover. That was Ritter who barreled in.
He delays here. Now he drives in. Chandler's not looking for Weathersby. He knocked the ball out of his hands. A mistake. And a big one.
Quickly for Earl Bruce. Now Carsados. Workman has carried the ball on every offensive play.
Now he's going to the left side, you see.
Second and nine. Carsados slipped as the rain starts to come down. Up by two. Maybe Mississippi State's pretty talented this year. Third and nine. And it was Workman, number 26. He knows how difficult it is to field a punt in this weather. And this one, people won't even attempt. What a great punt by Tupa. They nailed it out of bounds. Now it is up to Chandler to see if he can rally the Huskies again. He had him on the move before that fumble a moment ago. Straight ahead power football with Finney. Second and seven for the Huskies. Weathersby and Finney are the setbacks behind Chandler. And here he comes again. Finney. And in the rain, perhaps they could have difficulty on a snap, but not this time. Last year was a disappointment. A lot of injuries. They did defeat Colorado in the Freedom Bowl. Delay with Finney. Out past the 20-yard line. Second and six. Possible passing situation, but they're having good success on the ground with the rain coming down. And he went to Weathersby on a draw.
Here they are in the full house again.
This time they fake to Finney. It comes straight ahead with Covington. Ball at the 35. Washington has dominated the possession, but Ohio State is even up on that scoreboard. They swing Finney. Chandler looking the other way, puts it away, and runs up near the 45. There was a loose ball. Ohio State signaling that they recovered. But that time the whistle had blown, and the ball was down, and we have no instant replay in college football like they are using in the NFL. And on second down, Weathersby broke a tackle and battled for the first down. The Huskies have not gotten into the end zone. They'll throw on first down. Oh, overthrew. The rain coming down here in Seattle. Second and ten. They'll run out the quarter with the fullback. The end of our first quarter. State and Washington are scoreless. We'll return after this message and a word from your local stations. And as we start the second quarter, the Huskies switch into the I formation. This is a third and five inside the 50-yard line. Chandler to put it up. Incomplete, and there was interference.
There's the throw right there by Chandler. There's the contact. Well, actually, he was sitting there ready to intercept the football, and a defender ran into him.
The fullback, Finney, has rushed for 44 yards with 9 carries. There was a bit of a bobble there as Covington, 2nd and 5. Chandler with good time. And over on the far side.
Oh, face mask.
They're inside the 25. Finney with his 10th carry. 2nd and 7 here for Washington. The Buckeyes and the Huskies are scoreless.
Blitz.
And they took Finney down with it. 3rd and 12 for the Huskies. The ball is at the Ohio State 25. Knocked away, incomplete. And Jeff Jaeger will attempt a 42-yard field goal. It's good. Mr. Automatic. The Huskies score first. They lead it by a field goal. He does not have John Woolridge to spell it. Woolridge out with an injury. Jaeger gets that one to Workman. Out to the 20-yard line. Mr. Karsatos will attempt to rally the Buckeyes now, and he hands off to Workman, who had a hole on the right side.
But I think they want to get into field position before they start taking those chances.
Workman behind the left side. But not this time. They let him block, and Workman gets the first down. Karsatos again checking off at the line of scrimmage. Uh-oh. And they have an exchange fumble, and Karsatos pounces on it. Off a play fake. Karsatos with time goes toward Carter, and it's incomplete. They split the backs on third down. And here comes Cooper. Andre Riley.
Rush is long.
A beautiful punt. Drives Riley inside the 10. Aaron Tupas is keeping the Buckeyes in this game. In his earlier days, he too was a quarterback. I don't know if his leg has quite the whip that Reyes does. Finney on first down. 2nd down and 8. Chandler back. It's Franklin coming across, and he is short.
For the full house again with 2-3 fullbacks in the game.
And on 3rd and 1.
I don't know.
They power close to a first down. Slips. 2nd and 12. Chandler runs the draw with Finney. Franklin in motion. That inside pitch, and Weathersby with a hole. Nicely executed. And then they sealed up Spielman with a stand-up block. And they come back with Weathersby to the right side. An 0-2. That's not like Ohio State's football program, if that should be the case. Long way to go here. And Weathersby.
They're a solid football team. They're well-disciplined, fundamentally sound, and they like Lou.
Out of the full house, they did come up with a pass play for a first down. Upsets will roll in every Saturday, won't they, in this game? Hard to go unbeaten. Chandler downfield to Franklin. Franklin got the ball at the 2-yard line. Did he make that catch? The handoff to Finney, who bucks in. The first touchdown here this afternoon is scored by Finney. Jaeger nails that extra point. Mr. Automatic. Story here, a young offensive line coming of age, blowing away the Buckeyes on defense. It's 10-0 Washington. Led to him getting the job here a little over a decade ago. And this Washington team could be a real sleeper this year before it's over. Here comes Workman. Fumble, Washington. And there's a penalty flag down.
Oh, it's against the Buckeyes.
You would think it's New Year's Day with a Pac-10 doing this to the Big Ten, wouldn't you?
They've done it a few times, haven't they? That was the option.
Chandler kept it. Both wide receivers were to the left, and they came with Weathersby inside the 15. Third downs here this afternoon against the Buckeyes. They run that second man behind Finney, Aaron Jenkins. So they're continuing to use the formation. They doubled both wide receivers, as they have been doing, to the left. And they ran Finney down near the 7-yard line. Ball is loose. We'll see if the whistle blew. Great run by Weathersby. Make them pay dearly. 17 to nothing. They fumbled the last kickoff. That'll be a penalty. Race for the Heisman Trophy. So after the penalty is marked off, that kick you into the hands of Holland. Out to the 27 and stays on his feet. Holland, Carter, and Harris. Taggart is out.
Same scene.
Carter dipped back a little bit.
Both times on those passes, Carter has been wide open. They haven't doubled him. There's a draw.
Fumble. Workman puts it on the rug, and Washington will take at least a 17-0 lead into the locker room. Earlier in the first quarter, the Huskies fumble once, ending a drive. Chandler going long. Hill, he's got it down the sideline, but he's out of bounds at the 10-yard line. The thrill is back. 46 yards. The win up 17-0. They are assured of 3 points with Jaeger. They hit Jones, the tight end, and perhaps the best field goal kicker in college football. The lob to Hill. Washington over Ohio State. Jaeger takes it toward the end zone, and Everett Ross, who replaced Workman. Workman fumbled once on a kickoff. Workman is out. The freshman, Jim Bryant, 41, goes into the backfield, and Carsados hits him right away.
See if he goes with a big one.
Down the right side toward Holland. Oh. Had a hand on it. Malone tried for the interception. Stepped up in front of the ball. As time runs out on the first half, and it's a half that the Buckeyes of Ohio State would dearly love to erase in the second half. The Huskies jump all over them. We'll have an update on that as Lou Holtz scores first against Bo Schembechler. Comes up a little flat to start the third quarter. Let's see if that's the case here this afternoon. Tomorrow's kickoff will be fielded by Steve Jones at the 2. 25 out near the 30-yard line. Let's see what James' staff wants to open up with here. Weathersby the tail. Good blocking on that right side. Chandler rolls left, and he hits Franklin. Here's the first down call for the Huskies. Fullback. And Finney breaks a tackle and still going. Second down and six. Chandler keeps it. Takes a lick as he rolls out to the right.
And the Buckeyes are not deployed in the short yardage defense.
Moves the pocket. Defense breaks through. And they get him at the 49-yard line. Now the Washington punter. Gets it up in the air from Thane Cleland. And the ball fielded by Everett Ross.
It pains me to even think about it.
I'm sorry. I apologize. I shouldn't do that. Parsanos on first down. Off the fake. Throws it complete. And he gives to Jim Bryant, the freshman. He's got room out to the 33. Puts it on the carpet. Washington recovers. The third Ohio State turnover. James Baxter split. Chandler on first down. Drops it to Weathersby. They were setting the screen. On the left side to Goodwin. This could be his down and distance, too. Instead, they'll use Weathersby.
Go back upstairs.
All right, Pat. Here's Weathersby. There's a penalty marker down. Ahead of Michigan, 14-7 moments ago. Chandler, receivers were covered. He puts it away and gets to the 17-yard line. Trying desperately to rally this team. Now on a first down, Weathersby up the gut. So much for the Volunteers in the top 10. Finney. Great play by Camaro coming in defensively. 39-yard field goal attempt by Jaeger. If he hits it, he would break the school scoring record held by Chuck Nelson. He's got it. One more record for Mr. Jaeger. What a weapon it is to have a kicker with a leg like that. Was Mr. Donahue down in Los Angeles, I'd say, uh-oh, the Huskies are back. Off to Everett Ross, number 5 of the Bucks. Oh, we found a weakness with him. The Chevrolet MVP. We'll announce him as soon as this game comes to a conclusion. Jaeger's next kickoff to Holland at the 3. Short of the 25-yard line.
Of his brother, Don Rogers, the Cleveland Browns, who tragically died over the summer from an overdose of cocaine. It was a devastating week, the day before his wedding.
It is indeed more than football, isn't it? A lot of times. Carsanos on the play fake, looking to get something going, goes toward Carter, and it's incomplete. They'll have at least decent field position. Away from it and let it roll dead down inside the 30-yard line. So we'll come back,
see what happens the rest of the game, but it's a great start for Lou Holtz and the Fighting Irish.
Chandler enjoying a fine afternoon. He slipped on that exchange. Here is second and 13. Motion, inside handoff, fumble. Chandler is 11 of 15 for 162 yards and that one touchdown to Mo Hill, as he is known by his teammates. Over the middle, intercepted. At the 45-yard line, Greg Rogan. The Bucks with excellent field position. They come with the tailback, Workman and Harris, the wide receivers. Here is Bryant. He squirted. Carsanos under pressure delivers it to Carter, who had fallen down and working at that strong safety spot. He has replaced James. They run the draw. Big hole on the right side. Second down and 2. Step left, pitch back, Cooper. Good play. Down to the 10-yard line. Bryant for the nine. Carter, touchdown, Ohio State.
Tough to stay with man-to-man. Malone was trying to stay with Carter. It's awful tough. They were trying to blitz him. Protection was good. And, of course, he hit him for the touch.
Pulled it to the left, but through.
They can see what turnovers do, Brent.
Buckeye fans will never forget that afternoon. He ran out of his shoes for a touchdown. So Amaro's kick, a little bit short, fielded by Steve Jones. There's an alley on the right. And the safety man, number six, Holland. The ball's at the 47 for the Huskies. Split backs. They run Weathersby behind the right side of it. Second down and eight. Weathersby slips.
Now, finish that thought right after this play.
Chandler with good time, but now he can't get a receiver open. Drops it off to Finney on an escape pass, and his fullback down to the 45.
On the play.
Cleland to punt again. He hurries it. Not a good punt, but it takes a Washington bounce. Inside the 10-yard line. The ball is bouncing right for the Huskies.
That's about right.
1:22 left in the third. Garcetto's from the end zone. Under pressure, just did get it off. Second down and 10. This is Workman, third and eight for Ohio State. In his end zone again, incomplete. Pressure's blocked. Touchdown, Washington.
Close. And that time it was too close for him. Uh-oh.
They botched the snap. Chandler throws for two, but it's incomplete. And they will be passing out the roses after this one in Seattle. The Huskies are back.
Peoples came to Washington as a wide receiver. Moved him over to defense, and he demonstrated he's caught a hitter.
Holland swinging right down at the 31-yard line. And the doubleheader will match the Niners against the Rams. Here it's first down for Carsados over the middle. He completes the ball. 15 minutes left. The Buckeyes trail the Huskies 30-37. We'll be back after these messages from your local station. Buckeyes will be 0-2 as Workman comes up the middle to the 45. It is rare for Ohio State. Instead, it looks like the Buckeyes are going to be digging uphill. It's first and 10. Carsados. Incomplete. Malone.
Down.
End around. Holland looking for daylight. Rodgers is right there.
Why were they waiting
no
on?
No way. On second and 17. Great catch right over the middle of Workman. Typical air. BYU. Here it's Carsados on the third down. Going deep down the middle. Incomplete. He overthrew Carter. High punt back toward the end zone. And it's going to go in and come back out on the ball control. Conservative approach behind that big offensive line. Give them some drive blocking experience.
Particularly deep in their own territory.
Weathersby, long counts, doing anything they can now to take seconds off that clock. Weathersby smacked that time. It's a very well-organized coaching staff. Third down, they get the man open right now. They hit Jones, the tight end. Not too often on opening day, you have it.
No, not on opening day.
First and 10, drops it, intercepts. intercepted, badly thrown ball at midfield, and that is David Brown. Tom Tupa is the Ohio State quarterback. Hands off to Workman, who gets across midfield. Second and eight. Stands in, drops it off, and Workman should have had it.
Dotto's watching Tupa quarterback the team right now.
Incomplete. He forced that ball.
Uh-oh.
Well, off the snap, Tupa slipped when he came back down. Boy, I'll tell you, that is another fine play.
What a play that
get
is.
Steve Jones is now the tailback. He has replaced Weathersby for the Huskies. He's a good-looking fullback. 10:15 to go here in Seattle. And the Huskies run Jones.
I remember that year, Coach.
So do I.
Here comes Jones again. Daylight. What a run by Jones. Benny. Second and seven.
Yards. They're going to get 200 yards on the ground.
Here's Finney. Chandler's right back over the middle. Complete. And there he is. There's your guy, Coach. Lonzell Hill for six.
Just talking about that fellow.
That's in nine plays, I believe, as Jager nails down another one. I believe, Mr. Parsegan, that when I vote in the AP football poll this week, that I'll put these Huskies in the top 10. Corner right on into his career at Ohio State. Buckeyes get possession here with 6 minutes left in the game. Everett Ross being run back. Keep you updated on all those games tomorrow. So they run the tail. Jim Bryant, the freshman. Bryant is stuck hard. All right, Jim, thank you. And I'm sure we'll have all the scores running down at the conclusion of this game. Incomplete pass.
Now let's get a state to start the season. Let's get rid of that.
Better get ready.
Tupa's punt is low. Fielded at 37 by Riley. Losing his balance.
He did have a great day, Pat.
And there's the freshman, Kerry Conklin, out of Yakima, Eisenhower. But Lou Holtz has the Fighting Irish back in business, doesn't he?
Yeah, he sure does. I mean, if we're hanging in there that way, 17-14.
Getting locked up with the memories of this thrashing. It's awful. I mean, the food's terrible on the airplane. Just get me out of here, you say.
It's going to be real quiet.
Oh,
real.
Oh, and the coaches get that play by of Columbus. Workman, who had come in to field that punt, got it at the 15.
That may be later in the season.
Ride with the fullback.
George Cooper, the
Wolverines get a little daylight. Well, here's the freshman, Bryant. Coach, you guys are all alike. They won't say nice game, and we want. Just how about this three interceptions?
Well,
got a tough schedule ahead, too.
We'll play Southern Cal next week.
First Brigham Young era and then Southern Cal. BYU comes up next week, then they go down to L.A. Tupa's pass incomplete, out of bounds. Third down and 10. Hand it off to that freshman. And Bryant runs it out to about the 47. You can win a game and make a lot of mistakes, and that's all forgotten. But you just lose one like this, and you'll rip yourself apart during the week. If he'd have done this, or we should have done that. You know. Tupa and the Buckeyes. And now the Huskies are storming through.
through the gates. The game has come to an end. 40-7. Don James consoling Jimmy Carsados. The Huskies with a big win. 40-7. What an impressive performance they turn in here today.